Good morning, amigos. Dr. Doug here at GoBodyTrust.com. How do you like my fez? I love it. I ran across an article the other day that was interesting. It says adverse events during first years of life may have greatest effect on future mental health. This is from the Massachusetts General Hospital. And it reminded me of so many cases of mental disturbance, especially autism, which is dramatically increasing these days. During that first years, the first years of life, they say before the three, before an infant reaches 3 years of age. If trauma hits that person before then, they can be psychologically damaged. And they found that it actually changes their genes. This is what happens in autism, for example, with over-controlling environment, a parent or parents, when a child is supposed to be rebelling big time, the terrible twos, anyway. You know, this just reminds me of phlegm. Phlegm is the culprit here. Now, phlegm will obscure the heart, the Chinese heart, right? And your shen lives in the heart. Now, shen is that substance, one of those five substances in my chapter 3 of my book. Shen is that substance that determines behavior. A healthy shen determines appropriate behavior, right? Appropriate to all the information that is available. The shen collects information from the heart. It collects it from intellect and memory, so rational thought and memory, and it also collects it from feelings, from mad, glad, sad, scared, and bored, and your five senses. Collects all that information, puts it together into a big picture, and chooses behavior. If the behavior is appropriate to all that information, it's healthy behavior. If it's not appropriate, it's unhealthy behavior. And what makes it inappropriate? Usually phlegm. So when the qi, you know, the qi is another substance from the five substances, and it moves everything. It moves jinya, another substance. Jinya is our fluids. So when the qi is stuck, because the mind is stuck on something, usually the future or the past, then the fluids, the jinya, doesn't move. And the phlegm, and that starts to pile up around the heart, and it causes phlegm. Phlegm can obscure that information, can make it like looking into a poor quality glass, a poor quality window that distorts it. That information comes through to the shen distorted. And that's when we start having serious psychological problems, because that behavior is no longer appropriate. In fact, it may be wildly inappropriate to the circumstances. That's what we call a disturbed shen. It's always going to be disturbed by phlegm. Now, we have two kinds of phlegm, of course. There's substantial phlegm, which is the phlegm that you see, you can see spit or whatever. It indicates a problem. That's substantial phlegm, and we can see there's also insubstantial phlegm. That is what surrounds the heart. You can't see it on a microscope, but we know it's there. Principally because the same herbs that remove substantial phlegm also help to remove insubstantial phlegm. In other words, it clears up the mind from phlegm, the shen. Starts to see things clearly anyway. Severe phlegm disturbing the heart, of course, is a bit of an emergency or heroic intervention situation that may require a drug, a pharmaceutical, to clear that phlegm. And then that person has to go back into that childhood trauma and get it right, and get that straight. And sometimes we'll have to have an emergency intervention in order to think clearly so that cognitive behavioral therapy can work, and mindfulness training and all that. So anyway, that's a disturbed shen due to phlegm surrounding your Chinese heart. That's all for today, Monday, amigos. See you tomorrow. Hasta mañana.